Plato, a great man from way back when, he said this: good people do not need laws to tell them to act responsibly, while bad people will find a way around the law. Pretty accurate stuff, don't you know? And in today's world, I gotta say, there's actually a new chapter, because some people, good people, find ways. They're now the ones finding ways around laws, because laws have been put in place to penalize them. It's a reverse, mixed up kind of system. They're manufacturing criminals every day. They be on the left wing, whack governments, just saying. Here we have a guy, his name is Sam Brownback. He's the governor of Kansas, and he just signed into law a Senate Bill number 45 that expands Kansas permitless open carry to include permitless concealed carry. You've got all that verbiage. Here's what it means. Under current law, if a gun becomes covered by a coat, or a woman prefers to carry a firearm for protection in her purse, he or she would need a concealed carry handgun license. The new law now simply extends permitless open carry. That means now you can walk around with a gun as long as it's in the open, okay? And if it isn't in the open, you got to have a permit, to permitless concealed carry, allowing now law-abiding gun owners to protect themselves and their loved ones in the manner that best suits their needs. Now, let me give you some stats on this. It's kind of interesting with regard to guns and laws and different things. There's now three states that have adopted a permitless carry law similar to this law. In Kansas, murder rates have gone down, declining by 23% in Alaska, 16% in Arizona, and 8% in Wyoming. And I want to aim this next comment at Canada. Canadian gun owners virtually have given up with regard to the gun laws, because they're just not protected, and all the bad guys have all the rights protecting them. Don't give up. It was only 15, maybe 20 years ago, not many years ago at any event, in America, no state had a concealed carry law. Today, every one of them does. And now you have this kind of stuff going on every day. As much as the left-wing press continues to expand their agenda, right, we're winning. We really are winning. And we're winning in Britain, we're winning in Australia, because people are starting to come out of the ether. They're looking at the numbers and saying, wow, maybe this is true. And then they look deeper into it, and guess what? It is true. When you carry guns in Texas, for instance, when Governor Bush signed that rule, or law rather, to make it legal to carry concealed, crime went down. Crime went down by 40-some-odd% in the first year. Criminals are scared of good people that can defend themselves. And it's going on everywhere. So Canadians, don't give up, because it might be coming to a province near you. Someday, some politician's going to man up. It's coming soon. The High Court in Canada recently ruled the federal government has a right to order the destruction of the gun registry in Quebec. And Quebec is saying, woe is us, but that's okay. We're going to create our own. We'll do it for $20, maybe $30 billion. You really think so? I mean, about a quarter of all the gun owners, possibly a third, are in Quebec. And you know that other gun registry that was going to cost $1 million, it cost several billion? I mean, kind of do the math. Take 30% of a couple or $4 billion, and you don't come up with $20 or $30 million. It's impractical. You're not going with the numbers. The citizenry, nobody needs it. So many people are saying, a registry will help me. Registries don't help anybody. Again, it's proven. You're registering a long gun. What's that got to do with a banana? How about nothing? I mean, it's just silly. And then you get all these women saying, hey, there'll be more murders if we don't get a registry. It's not true. It doesn't happen. But let's go to the final chapter with this. With regard to payment, who's going to pay for it? Probably Alberta. Albertans don't want to put a gun registry into a place like yours, because Quebec doesn't have any money. You're on welfare because you're pretty much a socialist state, right? Get with the bloody program, free enterprise and all of that. Criminal codes in Canada, mace, pepper spray. If your wife or daughter's going out jogging and you're worried about there's been a rapist in the area, or bears or dogs, and you give them a can of mace, you know what? That's under the criminal code, exactly like a gun. You know what your wife or daughter would get? 3 years in jail. I'm not kidding you. 3 years in jail. The inmates are in charge of the asylum. Russia, they finally figured it out, and they said, hey, we have so many murders in our country. A couple of years ago, they had 21,000 murders compared to America, who had 13,000 murders. And America has like 300 guns. Russia had 10 million guns. And of course, there's a whole bunch of people more, blah, blah, in America than there is in Russia. Greatness requires great risks. Hey, y'all, come back tomorrow. Get a more for you from the right. See ya.